you guys.
Hi guys.
Alright, you guys.
Hi guys.
Hi guys.
Hi guys.
This is
Iskolars Nina,
your guide today,
the hope of the future.
Hi guys.
Hi guys, this is the Iskolars Nina,
your guide today,
the hope of the future.
I am Teacher Fab.
And I am Teacher Rei, and together we are your host for the pilot episode of our PNUWhat series.
Alright, what a way to start the series!
I know, especially the intro. Winner!
Man, that intro is so intense, but not really as intense and interesting as our topic for today.
Whoa, is that right?
Yep.
What is our topic for today's episode then?
Well, since another school year is coming near, it is only timely we talk about one of the biggest dilemmas that every incoming college student faces.
Hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Okay.
I think I know where you're going here. Are we going to talk about career choices?
Not just career choices, sir, but we're going to weigh in between choosing one's passion or practicality as the basis of choosing their career path.
Oh, is that why we're carrying the passion versus practicality flag in that intro?
That is exactly why we are carrying those, sir.
You know what? That sounds interesting for me. Shall we start then?
Why not? Let's go!
Let's go!
Career, passion versus practicality.
Before we shoot this episode, we decided to confide to our friends, asking them the most important question for this episode. What did you choose between passion and practicality and considering your career path?
Based on this mini survey that we conducted among our peers, most of the answers that we received says that they choose practicality. Why do you think is that so, Teacher Fab?
I'm not really sure, sir, because for me, I chose education as my career because I was being practical. I mean, I do love to teach, but I chose it because I know that it would not be as hard. But man, I was so wrong.
I understand that, sir. There is no such thing as easy in the course of education. The E in education basically means angel.
That's very clever, Jer. But what about you? Was it passion or practicality that made you choose this path?
You know what, Teacher Fab? For me, it was also practicality. You know, since I was little, I dreamt of being a lawyer. And I wanted to be for my undergraduate program is philosophy or political science. But when I got older, I realized the essence and importance of money. You know, like, I don't want to be a burden for my family after I graduate, so I pursue education since I also love teaching and speaking, and I know when I graduate I can easily find a job, unlike my previous programs that I like or that I've said before. So win-win situation.
A win-win ended. Well, so far, do you think that your choice has been beneficial for you? Because personally, even though my practicality approach has been an epic fail for me, choosing education as my career path has been a wonderful experience for me so far. No matter how hard it gets, there's still this sense of accomplishment, right? You know what I mean, right? So yeah, I still love education even
that
though it's not
a wonderful teacher, Bob.
Yeah.
I can totally agree with you. On my part, if you ask me if I regretted here in the education program, no, none at all. I got my dream majorship program here, the social science. And through this journey, this whole academic year, it taught me a lot. You know, teacher, a lot. And not only in academics, but also it taught me to grow as a person, a better person. You know,
I agree with
it's such
you
a
on
fulfillment.
That, yeah, I agree with you on that, sir. Because, you know, I'm loving this conversation so far. I'm really loving it, you know?
Me too, teacher. Fab. I'm very emotional. But they say, shall we take a deeper dive into this topic?
PNUWhat, you're on.
Let's go.
Let's go.
In order for us to have a wider perspective regarding this topic, we invited two professionals who can share their experiences in choosing their career paths.
Currently, I am working as a junior software engineer at a company in Quezon City, and it was in the field of IT industry.
Yes, I'm currently working now, and I am in the field of construction design at the moment.
Currently, I am already 2 years in my company, and yes, I am thankful for that na hindi pa ako lumilipat ng company. I graduated way back May 10, 2019, then after that, mga May 14, 2019, nagsimula na akong magtrabaho because of matinding pangangailangan, which is, alam yun, ng mga panganay.
I'm already around 32 years in this field, in this field of construction and design.
Yes, I choose passion way back nung high school, but when I enrolled in college, nung nasa PUP na ako, naisip ko and na-realize ko na ang importante palang piliin ko ngayon ay yung practicality. Because naisip ko noon nung panahon yun, mahal mag pre-med course. Like, mahal yung course ngayon, marami kang kailangan na course. And as a panganay, ayoko nang maging burden sa family ko and magdagdag ng alalahan sa kanila. That's why I strive harder to become scholar sa DOST and sa CHED para wala nang maging burden. And also, tinry ko talaga, pinili ko yung sa sarili kong kunin yung course na alam kong practical, na kaya kong matapos nang hindi gumagastos yung parents ko.
Well, I think I considered passion because since I was young, I really loved to draw, and that's why I took up architecture in college.
For me, the pros for my answer or choosing practicality is, number one, with my course in college, my college degree, it was so in demand, yes. Kasi naririnig ko dati na itong course na to, ganyan-ganyan, yung COMSA is in demand siya sa industry. Like, it's a high-paying job. Well, totoo naman, it's a high-paying job. One of the high-paying job yung trabaho na nasa industry ng trabaho ng COMSA.
Well, maybe because in life, you need to consider passion because it will help you to succeed, no? It will help you to progress in your career, because if you don't have passion in your career, maybe you will not succeed.
For me, the cons of this choice is hindi mo alam yung sisimulan mo. I mean, hindi kasi ito yung nakatatak sa isip mo. Like, when I was in college, I realized that what I'm choosing and what am I doing, kung ano yung ginagawa ko, ito ba yung talaga yung pangarap ko? Like, I ask myself na, paano ba to? Like, how will I do this without enough idea what I'm doing? Like, hindi ko alam yung gagawin ko kasi hindi ito yung gusto ko. Hindi ito yung gusto ko, hindi ito yung naka-mindset sa isip ko nung bata ko na kapag laki ko, ito yung mangyayari sa akin or ito yung magiging career ko.
Oh, no. There's no negative effect. Actually, that's what I have mentioned. If you consider your passion, you will really succeed.
Well, for me, there's a two sides of it. Yun nga, it hinders me sa mga decision ko sa work. Like, minsan kapag hindi ko nagagawa yung ginagawa ko sa work, or yung task ko or yung current assigned na work sa akin, iniisip ko na eto ba talaga yung eto ba talaga yung bumabalik ako dun sa Excel ng eto ba yung kailangan kong eto ba yung dream ko, eto ba yung purpose ko, like eto ba yung pangarap kong maggawin sa buhay ko. Then yun yung nag-a-affect sa akin, but then for me hindi siya naging balakid sa pagiging success ko sa buhay. Well, for me, hindi pa ako successful in life. I must say na hindi pa ako successful because may mga pangarap pa akong hindi ko nakukuha, and ang growth and ang learning is continuous. Marami pang challenges ang mangyayari. And marami pang bagay na magtetest sa akin para sa career na to. But then, I must say na yung chosen, yung answer ko between passion and practicality, where I choose practicality, for me, it doesn't hinders me to become who I am today, to become a good professional. Good professional, I mean to become a someone who is taking the career in his college degree. Like, tama ba yung sagot ko? Hindi, yun. Parang hindi ito naging balakid sa akin para makuha ko yung gusto ko. Like, makakuha ko ng settled job and high-paying job, yon, hindi siya naging balakid sa akin.
No. Definitely not. Like what I have mentioned, if you choose a career which is pushed by your passion, then you can easily get it, and then you can easily reach your goal because it was your passion.
That was it from our guest, one insightful interview, right, Ray?
Yes, and now that we are done with weighing both options, do we have a final winner between the two? Is it passion or practicality?
Well, the majority of the people that we asked have chosen practicality over passion. So maybe it is safe to say that in one's choosing one's career path, practicality is the right
thing. Yes, and it is also based on the stories that we heard. We can see how choosing practicality over passion has actually helped them more in succeeding in life.
Yeah, but I agree. But even if practicality has won your episode, let me just clarify that we are not professionals, and thus you should not take our words as a guarantee for your future, okay? This is merely our opinions.
That is right, Picture Fab. I agree with you. In addition, guys, personal advice. Choose something you see yourself in the future. Just like me, I see myself speaking in front, advocating, and empowering. So here I am in the teaching field where I know I can apply those visions that I have, and hello, who knows, years later I will be attorney Reina Josea C. Changson, LPT.
Wow. Let's go.
And that's all, and we hope that through our chicas and the stars that we shared with you, you too can find the career path that suits you best and that will lead you towards your bright future.
That's right. I don't know about you, Teacher Ray, but I feel very satisfied with today's episode.
Same here, Teacher Fab. And the best part about this is that this is the only beginning of our PNUWhat series.
Oh, that is right. So tune in for the next episodes of our trilogy PNUWhat series.
This is the Scholars ni Inang,
your guide to this,
the hope of the future.
Signing off. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
And of course, hit the notification bell.